Hey guys, and welcome back to another More with Morrow's video. Today's video is going to be a Christmas decorate with me. Guys, I'm so sorry I've taken so long to get this video out. It's taken me 2 weeks off and on with editing and filming throughout a week and a half of different things that I was doing to decorate for Christmas. But regardless, it's here now, and I hope that you guys will enjoy it. You guys can see my house is looking at Georgia just missed the couch. Did you guys see that? I swear she is like a little ninja though. She like hops and jumps around all the furniture. You guys can see my house. I don't even have pillows on the couch right now. It is so bare in here. I've taken all of the decorations down. Well, the fall decorations. Are you excited for your first Christmas? Are you excited for your first Christmas? But as you guys can see, no decorations. We still have to put up this Christmas tree. We're gonna have to wait until Frank gets back because he is on a hunting trip. He'll be back Sunday. So we're gonna put that tree up and decorate it. But everything is pretty bare at the moment. Looking pretty bare and sad. And I forgot I need to take that wreath off the front table as well. So here's all of our Christmas decorations that I am about to go through and get out. And I have decided this is how I'm gonna look. I'm gonna feel comfortable. I'm going to be relaxed while decorating and try to get into the Christmas spirit. And hopefully you guys will as well if you celebrate Christmas or just the holiday spirit. Let's just say the holiday spirit. Get into the holiday spirit and you guys can enjoy this video of me transforming our house into, I was gonna say Christmas Wonderland. It's not gonna be a Christmas Wonderland, but just transform my house into a cozy Christmas feel kind of vibe. But just watch me decorate. That's pretty much what this video is gonna be. I get so many cleaning decoration ideas from watching other people, so I'm hoping that this video can also do that for you guys. So let's get started. So like I tell you guys, it's always important to start with a clean slate. So I went ahead and took down all of the fall decorations. I feel like they were so short-lived that or time is really just going by so fast. And I know a lot of people traditionally want to start decorating after Thanksgiving, but I look at it this way. Why enjoy all your Christmas decorations just for 1 month? Especially if I'm gonna take the time to do all the decorating, I want to enjoy them a little bit longer. Am I right? Also, if you are wanting that more cozy feel, or let's say if you don't have a fireplace, there's actually background videos that you can find on YouTube. Just type in Christmas backgrounds into your search and a whole bunch of videos, like 2-3 hours long, so we'll just play continuously, you can pick from on YouTube. So since we already have a fireplace, I picked a snow background since it rarely snows in South Carolina. Actually, as I was opening this box and getting all the stocking stuff out, I realized I was just decorating for Christmas. Like, I feel like I was just decorating. And don't get me wrong, I love decorating for Christmas, but the past year, 2021, has gone by so fast, and I already know like this holiday season is gonna go by even faster. So that's why I really want to be able to get all my decorations up, be able to enjoy them, have that cozy feel in the house. I just love, there's nothing like that Christmas ambiance. Is that the right word? There's nothing like that. And even where we live, I wish that it would snow to even have more of that cozy Christmas feel. So this year I really tried to make it as cozy as I possibly could, despite it really not getting that cold here. I mean, sometimes it does, but below 50 for us is like freezing. And clearly making sure I get everything cleared off the mantle. I brought out the magic eraser and everything. And this year, since we have launched Simply Etched this past, what, May? Was it May or June? I can't even remember. But we came out with our own stocking tags. We made these with our laser and did like a 3D lettering, as you guys can see. And we are so proud and so excited to launch these. Actually, the day that I filmed or started filming for this Christmas video, we launched our tags and we sold out, you guys, in less than 24 hours. It was crazy. And we are gonna be restocking soon. I feel like I keep saying that over and over, but we were able to get our hands on some more tags, but shipping has just been taking
forever, way longer than we anticipated. We kept getting shipping updates that it was going to be delivered this day and this day, and then it's just been prolonged, which that's just, I feel like everything like that is, or everything right now is like that. So thank you guys so much for being patient. Just make sure you are following our Instagram page, Simply Etched Co. I'll leave it down in the description. Just make sure you guys are following us over there, because you will get updates when new products launch or new products are in stock. So definitely be on the lookout for that. So you guys know how I have a pillow addiction or obsession, whatever you want to call it, and I recently realized that I don't have to spend so much money on throw pillows. I can buy the covers, have the inserts, and just change out the covers. I know, this is something people have been doing forever now, and I'm very late to the game, but why did I not realize this sooner? Because I could have saved myself so much money and also space. Definitely a lot more space. So I found these really pretty green velvet soft pillows on Amazon. I already had the inserts, so I just got the covers, and it's actually the same ones that I got for the girls' room. So I'll make sure to leave a link down below for you guys so you guys can grab those as well and not waste all your money on throw pillows like me and just buy the covers. Let me know if you guys already do this, where I can find some cute covers. I know Amazon's like always my go-to, but if there's anywhere else, please let me know. So in the process of decorating for Christmas, I also did a lot of cleaning. So I wiped down all of the black chairs, or all of our dining room chairs. I say black because you can literally see everything on them. Smudges, dust, crumbs, dirt, everything and anything. I love the look of them, but yeah, you can definitely see everything. So I made sure to wipe them down really good and get them nice and clean. Actually this year, I didn't buy that much new decorations. I think I bought just a few new things, like some wreaths. I think where I got the most stuff was for the front porch. So you guys will see that here in a little bit, where I decorate the front porch. I did something a little bit different this year, putting garland around the door, and I got some a tree that I actually ended up flocking, that you guys will see later on in this video as well. I'll kind of take you guys through that process on how to flock. But for the most part, I used all of my decorations. What I like to do, and I've learned this over the years, is you do not have to buy new decorations all year. I don't think that's practical. I don't think that you need to. What I usually do is I'll switch things around, because I do have a lot of decorations and I do have a lot of stuff in storage. So I'll just recycle, or just cycle out those decorations. So one year I'll use like a certain amount of decorations or certain ones, and then not use some of them. And then the following year I'll use the ones that I didn't from last year, just to kind of keep it different, because I do like change. I do like, I am a creature of habit, but I do like change at the same time. So just to reuse your decorations and just change them up, put them in different places. That's what I've done for the past, I would say, 3 years, and just having no stress worrying about getting new decorations or anything like that. I don't have to worry about that anymore. I think that was just like something that was set in my head, that social media influenced me to have new stuff every single year. And like I said, it's just not practical at all. Actually, speaking of reusing stuff, I have had those garland ties for at least a good 5 or 6 years, and I've just reused them. That's what I love about them. They're like $2-3, and they are perfect for hanging up garland, especially when it comes to hanging up garland on your stairway. But I think you can use it also for other things as well, like ornaments or decorating outside. But I just used them this year for my garland, even though one of the pieces you guys will see doesn't go all the way to the top, but it's okay. I made it work. Do you guys remember that one year that I used real garland and I put it all over the stairwell and it was huge. I gotta go back and look at the video of that because I just remember, like, I will never do that again. I love the look of real garland, but it was a mess. It was not good. It was not a good time cleaning that up. But now I'm just replacing all of the batteries for the lights that go in the windows, the candeliers, I think that's what they're called. I've used these for years and years and years as well. And I think they just add like a nice touch, a cozy touch to the outside of your house. Actually, we did end up decorating the outside this year, but we did not film it. So we didn't film any of it. And we actually did a little bit more lights and now I'm like regretting not filming it, but we just spent the whole day putting up lights outside, so I might try to get a video for you guys in this video, or you guys can probably see it on my Instagram. I'll put it on my Instagram. Also, every single time that I go back and I rewatch these videos when I'm editing, every single time I see myself using a command hook or command strip, I always think I need to get command to sponsor one of my videos, because I feel like every single video I am using either a command hook or a command strip. You guys, I use them for everything. Like, just in this video alone, I use them for the hooks, for the wreaths, and I've also used them on the mantle. You guys saw when I was hanging up the garland, and then we use them outside for our lights. We use them for literally everything. So guys, help me try to get a sponsorship with command. I love them. I use them for everything, and you don't have to put holes in the wall with nails or screws. You can just use command strips or hooks. So the one thing that I love about these candeliers is that you can set them on a timer. So yes, they are battery powered, but what I do is around dark time, or it gets night around like 6 p.m., I turn the timer on, and that way it, I forget how long it stays on, but it eventually goes off like in the middle of the night, and then come 6 o'clock, you don't have to turn the switch on, but come 6 o'clock the next night, they'll turn on by themselves. So that's what I really like about those lights. You don't have to worry about them. You just leave them in the window and they're already on their timer. I actually got a candle as well for the front porch. You guys will see that for this little new lantern that I got. And it also has a timer as well. So it's just like one less thing, because I know sometimes it can be stressful to remember to turn on all the Christmas lights, or well, we keep our Christmas tree on all the time. I know I'm like crying in electric bills right now, but we just keep it on all the time. But I know it can be kind of stressful, you know, remembering to turn everything on, because just it's like there's so much lights and power and everything and batteries involved with Christmas. But this year, speaking of our tree, we decided to put our tree in the living room. So usually we will put it behind the couch, if you guys know what I'm talking about, that area right behind the couch. But this year we decided to put it on the other side of the fireplace where there's nothing, just empty space. And I was a little worried that it was gonna be too big or look awkward there. I know it's blocking some of the shelves, but it's okay. We're okay with that. But it ended up actually going really well there and fitting perfectly, and didn't make our living room feel, I mean, it's definitely a little bit more cozy now, that's for sure, but it didn't make it feel like super small or closed off. So I think from now on, we might keep it here the remaining time that we are in this house. And it's just really cozy by the fireplace, and seeing it when you go down the stairs. Like, I always try to picture like what the kids are gonna see when they go downstairs when Santa comes and it's time to open presents and it's Christmas morning. But something about this tree fit very perfectly in this corner. So I don't know, I think it looks beautiful. And I know I might get questions about what kind of tree, Christmas tree we have. So we have a twinkly tree. I think this is our third year with it or having it, and we absolutely love it. So it's an artificial tree, but it looks, you guys can see up close, it looks so real, the outside, and then the lights are already on the tree, so we don't have to put lights around it, and you can actually change it to different colors and patterns, and it even syncs with the music. You guys, it's really cool. It's probably like the coolest Christmas tree I've ever seen in my life. All right, so now to the fun part. I love to flock Christmas trees. You guys remember the Christmas tree? Well, you might not remember if you're new to the channel, but I had flocked a whole Christmas tree a few years ago and I loved it so much. So I found this little tree at Target for $20. I bought the flock on Amazon. Now it took a while to get in, so I don't know if you guys can get it in time. I might link it below just in case. But the art of flocking is actually very simple. You're just going to spray your tree all the way around with water and then take a strainer, and it's really messy, so just a heads up. You're just going to take your flocking powder and put it in your strainer and just sift it all over the tree. You can do as much or as little as you want, and then you're just going to spray on top of that and it seals in the flock and let it dry and it looks like snow on your tree. And you can do this with bigger trees, you can do this with also live trees, you can do it pretty much on anything. You could do wreaths, like the one that you guys see on the front door. I didn't do that, I bought it like that, but if you wanted to, you can definitely do something like that for sure. So I'll put it down below. All you need is a strainer, spray bottle with water, and then the flocking dust or powder, whatever it's called. But this year, like I said, I did something different with the front porch. I actually got this garland at Michael's for I think 40 or 50% off. And of course, used my command hooks to put it up there. Actually, no, I didn't. That's right. Frank had to go in and put a nail because it kept falling down. So command hook kind of failed me there, but otherwise I still love you. But I also got this tree, or Frank got this tree from me at Lowe's, and I thought it was pretty neat. So I put it on the front porch along with the lantern and the candle that I was talking to you guys about, and then my flocked Christmas tree. I got like a little basket to put it in from Target, and then I just put these lights that I also got from Target up around it as well. And I really love how it turned out. I think from now on I'm definitely gonna decorate the front porch like this. And then I just ended up putting a red bow at the top to kind of hide where the garland met. But I just realized that is all the Christmas decorating that we did, minus the Christmas lights outside because we haven't got to show you guys that yet. But that is all of my Christmas decorations this year. You guys know I have like a very simple, mild Christmas decorating method or way of decorating. That's just how my style is. But regardless, I do hope that you guys enjoyed this Christmas decorating with me and enjoyed watching me decorate my house for the third or fourth year in a row. Please give this video a thumbs up if you guys did, and I'll try to link as much stuff as I can down below that I showed or mentioned in this video. But I just wanna say thank you guys so much for watching. I love you guys, and I'll see you in our next one. Bye guys.